Hello, how are you? Magandang araw sa inyo. It is nice to be back. And when we gather together, remember, we are praying. And the fact that we are with our Blessed Mother, there is no way to be with her except to be in the state of union with God. That is what prayer is. Remember what Saint Teresa of Avila said? Oración es comercio de amor. It is an exchange of love. We know very well that our Blessed Mother loves us so much. She is really a mother to us. And she is the most wonderful mother because she is the mother of God. The mother of God who became a human being. And she is always united with Jesus, true God and true man. So whenever we are with the Blessed Mother, it is without doubt that we are with Jesus. And when we are with Jesus, He is our means to be with God, which is what God wants us to be for all eternity. And we are starting on this world to be with God. And so, how wonderful it is to have our Blessed Mother always around us. She visits us because we are her children. And that is her great duty before our Lord Jesus Christ. She wants us always to be close to her, and she assures that when she is with us, when she is our mother, we are brothers and sisters united to Jesus Christ. So let us remember that we are in the presence of the Lord, and our Blessed Mother is one with us. We don't only pray to her, we pray with her. And if our prayer is together with her, that is certain that we are being heard, and we are surely united to the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Almighty Father, thank you for gathering us again and again. And thank you for making us your children and giving us the mother of your Son, Jesus, through whom He became a human being, but He is the mother of God because Jesus is one person, 100% God, 100% human being. And His mother, the most pure virgin, according to your design and according to His words, She is also our mother, and she never stops telling us, reminding us, am I not your mother? And she never hesitates to visit us everywhere, sometimes with greater clarity. But she visits us all the time because she is after the safety, the salvation, the closeness to Jesus of all her other sons and daughters who became her children through her suffering with Christ on the cross. Thank you, Almighty God, and we beg you to make us so much, so changed into children of our Holy Mother so that you will see and she will see Jesus in us and in our own life, in our body as well as our spirit. It is very clear that it is Jesus who lives in us and we are totally transformed into Him. We ask this in the mighty name of your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Let us pray the salutation of the Holy Mother. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. The saints are always reminding us how powerful that prayer is. Most of our prayers, especially those in the Rosary, which the Blessed Mother insists that we pray again and again, these are powerful prayers. Why? Because they come from heaven. The Our Father is the prayer of Jesus, and we are entitled to call Jesus our Father, our Daddy. Or rather, call with Jesus the Father, our Daddy. Very intimate. And that is one of the result of our being children of Blessed Mother. The angel called her full of grace, full of God. She who visits us again and again, and she who is our companion in prayer, in our meditation, is full of God, full of Jesus, full of the life of the Spirit. She is so united to the Spirit because the Lord is with her. That is also her desire for all her children. Let us make sure that we are full of God, we are the dwelling place of the Lord, and we are always united to the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. In the apparitions of the Blessed Mother, which we have been always reflecting on, we always see her visiting poor children like Bernadette, no, illiterate, no, and very simple person. Also, the three children of Fatima, or the children of La Salette, the two children of La Salette. They're young and they are innocent, like the one of Nazareth. They're not even religious, no, but they were chosen by the Blessed Mother. And usually, the Blessed Mother appears to individual persons, like normally a religious person, like Saint Catherine Labore. The first recorded apparition is supposed to be the apparition to Santiago de Compostela, Nuestra Señora del Pilar. Juan Diego was an adult person, no? So mostly adult person and alone. So Saint Bernadette was alone when the Blessed Mother visited. Nobody else saw her. But this time, we are going to reflect on the Blessed Mother's visit to a place and to persons, even persons that whose names are never recorded, except a few, and that is in Chaitun. And normally, we see that the Blessed Mother appears to Catholics. Only we Catholics think of the apparition of the Blessed Mother, and there are so many, and usually to Catholic people, whether they're good Catholics or not, doesn't matter, but Catholics, no? This time, we will talk about the apparition of the Mother to a non-Catholic church, non-Catholic area. But as we have reflected in the recent apparitions, she makes it very clear that she is the mother of all, the mother of every person, because every person is being saved by Jesus Christ. The blood of the Lamb of God is applied to all men and women, whoever they are, even Catholics, even non-Catholics. And here we are going to talk about the apparition in Chaitun in Egypt. Why is this very important, Egypt? First of all, I said she did not appear to little children. She did not appear to individuals. Individual person. She did not appear to religious persons as before, but she appeared to a vast majority of people, anonymous people, and she appeared to, first of all, the church is not a Catholic church. It is a Coptic Orthodox church. There are Coptic Catholics. Coptic is the Christian description of in Egypt. The Christians in Egypt are Coptic Christians, different lines. They're not Latin right now. But a big part of them, of the Egyptian Catholics, and also Catholics in that area, that is Eastern, right? The big part of the Christians there are Orthodox Christians. Orthodox Church separated from the Catholic Church in the 10th century. They do not recognize the Pope of Rome, no? Now, the Blessed Mother appeared in a church, in a Coptic church, in Chaitun, Egypt, around 120 miles from Cairo, around Cairo, no? And she appeared to many. Two people who saw the Blessed Mother, of course, they did not know that she's the Blessed Mother, were Muslims. Workers, they saw the image of a woman so bright on top of the, it's like in the belfry of the Coptic Orthodox Church in Chaitun, near the cross. And they even thought that she was a young woman who was probably desperate and planning to jump from that high altitude down. And they were concerned. But after a while, maybe 30 minutes, she disappeared. This is another difference from the other apparitions. The Blessed Mother will appear several times in 3 years, once a week or even more often in 3 weeks. And she will be, because she had been appearing many times, there was a growing number of people until all people, they say, and up to even 500,000 people were present there. So 500,000 All of them saw that glow. Some of them saw the face of that beautiful woman. And they knew. They knew she is the Blessed Mother later on. No? And by the way, another difference is she never spoke. She never said a word to anyone. But she appeared many times. There were also appearances of, they say, doves. But they may be angels. Or they may be saints. The head of the Coptic Church, they call them Pope also, no? He said that the doves represent, we know very well, the doves are the birds, no? But the dove is also the sign of the Holy Spirit. So the doves represented the presence of the Holy Spirit. The Holy Spirit is always present where the Blessed Mother is, no? She is the spouse of the Holy Spirit. The dove also represents the church. The pure dove represents all the church. And the dove represents also the saints. But the dove also represents we, all of us, who in whom God dwells in our purity. So the Blessed Mother never said a word, but her silence was communicating a message. What is the message? First of all, in her silence, she is shown as the Almighty One of the Heavenly Person. The Heavenly Person. Number two, she is the mother of all persons, no matter what country you come from, what ethnic group you belong to, what religion. So those who went there and those who saw her were not only Coptic Christian, Orthodox Christians, but also Catholics, Protestants, Muslims, and all, you know, people came from everywhere. Gazing at that glow that sometimes reveals to some people, even scholars, no? Professors of the university in Cairo, and also visiting professors, having, leading tours, no? They were there. And many of them, they said, that some of them have said that they saw the face, the beautiful face of the Blessed Virgin Mary. You know, for the Muslims, the Blessed Virgin Mary is also virgin, and she is most holy. They revere her. The only thing that they don't accept is they said that they did not want Jesus claim that he is the Son of God. But the virgin birth, the fact that she's the mother of Jesus is virgin, Saint Joseph is not his father, he's only foster father, they believe in that. It is strange that they have not gone farther. If he is not, he does not have a human father, who is his father? Of course, for us Catholics, very clear. For Christians, very clear. Jesus is the Son of God who became a human being through the Blessed Virgin Mary. Anyway, the message that is being told in Chaitung is that here is the mother of all peoples. We reflected that in Amsterdam, the appearance of the Blessed Mother there started 1945 until I think almost the 90s. But here, 1968 to 1971, the Blessed Mother, in her silence, revealed that she is loved. She is recognized by all nations, by many peoples, by different ethnic groups. And remember, 68 is 1 year after the Six-Day War. One of those who saw the Blessed Mother, who was there, who came there specifically to join the other people in admiring the Blessed Mother, was the president of Egypt at that time, Nasser. Nasser is the leader of the Arab world, president of Egypt, who made war with Israel. That was a big disappointment for them. But from that time on, Nasser was very, very friendly to all Egyptian Christians. Before, they are always fighting. They don't like the Christians. But Nasser was a leader who appreciated the Christian faith even if he remained a Muslim, and that he is probably not a good Muslim at all. But he was influenced by that, and he saw the Blessed Mother, and there were so many others. So, what other teaching of the silence of the Blessed Mother? It is difficult times, no? All this, what we have been discussing all the time, why is the Blessed Mother appearing in so many places, in so many, to so many persons? Because she is the Mother of God. She is the Mother of Jesus. You can be sure, we must believe in that. The Blessed Mother is not coming to us so that we will admire her. Of course, we have no choice but to admire her. As she declared that, no, in all her lowliness, all generations will call me blessed. And that is what is happening. All generations consider her very much blessed by God and revered by many people. But it is very clear, I hope it becomes very clear to each one of us, that the Blessed Mother visits everyone, would like to visit all of us to warn us, telling us to go back to God. So whether you're Muslim, Catholic, Protestant, Orthodox, whatever religion, we must go back to God. Of course, what the Blessed Mother is doing is what Jesus would like to do, to unite all of us. That is the prayer of Jesus when he instituted the Holy Eucharist, that they all may be one, as you, Father, and me, as you, Father, are in me, and I am in you, that they also may be one in us. So unity. Unity of the human race. You know, that is not only the desire of Jesus. That is not only the plan of God. Even now, people would like to unite all. We forget all the boundaries. We forget all our different races. But when you desire unity or brotherhood outside the fatherhood of God, that is not the right kind of unity. There will be problems, and that is what is happening. So you bring about unity in a country, you destroy all your enemies. In Jesus' way, you unite everyone, you unite every person, you bring them to the unity of God in one family by forgiving, by loving your enemies, by caring for one another, by being at the service of everyone, thinking less of your own selves, but more of the others. When everybody is thinking of the good of others, then there will be that real unity, based not just on the fact that we are all brothers and sisters, but we have one Father, one Heavenly Father, who cares for us, who unites us to Himself. So the Blessed Mother is sent by Jesus precisely to continue. They're always together. There are many apparitions to Blessed Mother. She brings the child Jesus with her, or even the adult Jesus. They are together, the Sacred Heart and the Immaculate Heart. What is the purpose? She wants all of her children, that God Himself made her mother of all, so that all will be united to Christ. So it is Christ who sends her. What is the silent message of the Blessed Mother? Things are going wrong. People are going against God, even fighting God. And you know, when you fight God, you also do harm to others. That is what is happening in the world. That's why we are not surprised why the Blessed Mother comes again and again, different places, visits people. 1968, she was in Chaitung, and it is to tell Catholics, Protestants, Orthodox, Muslims, we must live together. We must recognize the same God as one who loves us so much, if possible. And we Catholics have a big role to play to achieve this dream of God. Everybody must know At least everybody should experience, especially at the last moment of one's life on earth, that the only salvation is in Jesus Christ, who is true God who became a human being. That is the concern of the Blessed Mother. That is the reason, real reason why she comes to the world, to tell the world that God's love is shown in the sacrifice of Jesus Christ. And the reward for those who accept Jesus Christ in their lives and who are accepted by Jesus in His life will be glorification. What is glorification? You live in the glory of God. You share in the eternity, in the immortality of God. You share in His eternal happiness. We are meant for that. That is the call for every person. We are not just human beings destined to live a few years here on earth and then disappear, or we are being transformed into other things. No, we are being transformed into Christ. We become more and more God's children. We must become one with Him. Chaitung was that very clearly. The Holy Mother came to Egypt silently. That was not the first time the Blessed Mother came to Egypt. And the Orthodox Egyptians and even the Muslims, even the ordinary Egyptians know this story. The first time that the Blessed Mother came to Egypt was during the time of Herod the Great. The Holy Family had to flee to Egypt. Joseph, Mary with the child Jesus, because Herod wanted the head, wanted the death of the child Jesus. He was the anti-God already in the beginning of the life, the earthly life of the Savior. So they went to Egypt, and it is said that, the tradition says that not only that she or the Holy Family passed through Chaitung, but stayed there in that area. They lived for 3 years in Egypt. So Jesus Christ was in the Egyptian environment for 3 years. By the way, we should remember that that is part of the Holy Rite, because Jesus personifies the people of God. The people of God, the first called to become God's people are the Jews. And they stayed for 4 centuries in Egypt during the famine, during the time of Joseph. You remember Joseph, the patriarch, one of the 12 sons of Jacob, who was sold by his own brothers. No? Reuben, the eldest, was defending, trying to save him. No? But he was sold, he was supposed to be killed by the brothers. No? That is the story of humanity, brothers killing brother. No? He was supposed to be killed by the brothers out of jealousy, because he is loved by the father, by Jacob, in a very particular way, because being the son together with Benjamin of Rachel, the most beloved wife of Jacob. But that was a tool of God in order to protect the people. So there was great famine, and at that time already Joseph bought a slave by the Philistines, no? And sold to Egypt. He became famous in Egypt because he had prophetic talent, and he reinterpreted the dream of the Pharaoh. He became the second most powerful person in Egypt. By the way, he was hated by his own brother because he dreamt and innocently narrated the dream that there were the stalks of grain bowing before one that remained straight, and that one is Joseph, which means that the day will come when Joseph will be considered someone honorable, high in the sight of man, and all the others, including his own brothers, will be paying homage to him. And that did not sound good for the brothers, so they tried to kill him. And they now because they saw the caravan of the Philistines, no? They sold him instead to become a slave. But that was the plan of God. He became their savior, Joseph, patriarch. So he became the regent. He ruled Egypt after the Pharaoh, and he was able to save Egypt from the famine that afflicted the whole world. And then the Jews, the family, his brothers came to Egypt to seek help, to be saved from famine. And then they remained there. We know the whole story. They remained there. Now, Jesus' story is also that he would be like Egypt. From Egypt, I have called my son. And that is why Chaitung is the place, they say, where the Blessed Mother and Joseph and Jesus stayed for 3 years until Herod died. Now, this is the other message of the apparition of the Blessed Mother, the silent message of the Blessed Mother, because she did not say anything at all. In 68, by the way, in 68, you know, that is the year that Pope Paul VI came out with Humanae Vitae against contraception. He was attacked, assailed, even by Catholics, even by theologians, for repeating and proclaiming the doctrine of the Church from the very beginning, that marriage is meant to bear children. Contraception means you refuse conception. You know, matrimony, that is marriage, no? Matris munire. Matris is the place where the baby lives, in the womb of the mother. Munire means to defend. The house that of the unborn child must be defended by all means so that life will be preserved. Herod, in the beginning of the earthly life of Christ, when he was born, intended to kill, and he did kill so many young innocent children. Of course, postpartum, no, after birth. But in 1968, and slowly, abortion becomes the law in most countries. That is why the Blessed Mother spoke about the world's turning away from God, and the sign of that is abortion. Remember, well, I think we mentioned it several times here, that according to Sister Lucia, the Holy Mother said in Fatima, the last assault of the devil against God and humanity is the destruction of the family. What destroys the family? Abortion, divorce, same-sex union, euthanasia, all of that, all death bills that are being passed, that have been passed in many parliaments and legislatures of the world and are being introduced in our own country. Probably we are the last bastion of true Christianity in the world. Now, the Blessed Mother is so concerned about that, that infidelity to God is increasing, and the sign is the assault against the family. So even in Chaitung, where she is mother of all, she is concerned even of the unborn, and she is mother of all them. She speaks to all of us. We better listen. And so our prayer is that we reflect on the great initiatives of our Blessed Mother, because that is her role before her son Jesus. She's reminding us to remain true to God. That's why she calls for penance, return to God, prayer, especially the rosary. You know, the prayer of the rosary is reflecting on the life of Christ as lived by the Blessed Mother. The life of the Blessed Mother completely dedicated to Christ. That should be our life too. Let us reflect on that, and let us be one always with Christ. The best way is the Eucharist. This is the call. Let us heed the call of our Blessed Mother. Almighty Father, how wonderful it is that your Son, out of your love for us, became a human being, suffered and died for us, in order that we will share your glory. Through the intercession of our Holy Mother and her guidance, may we truly do your will all the time, that we will come, we will, like your Son, accomplish what you want us human beings to become, to be transformed into your divinity and share your glory. It is you who loved us so much, you want us to be with you. Help us to love you in return, like our Blessed Mother, in all purity, and follow all what you want us to do, so that we'll be accomplished your will as your Son did. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. And may Almighty God bless you all, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Please subscribe, continue to be with us periodically, and pray with us, and tell others. Share this with others. We are not just telling you information. We are giving you formation, and the one who really forms us into sons and daughters of God, transforming us into her Son, that is our Blessed Mother. She is truly our mother. We must always tell her, please help me. Am I not your son? Am I not your daughter? Am I not your child? God bless you.